how to spice up your vocal track when all you have is one take. It's been a while since I've done one of these. Okay. In an ideal world, producers would obviously be armed with all the vocal tracks that we would ever possibly need to make a good song. Chorus, hook, verse, backups, harmonies, ad-libs, everything. But we don't live in a perfect, ideal world, do we? But does that mean we can't do just as much with the tracks we get? Yes, it does technically mean that. But there are some things we can do to make a boring one-dimensional vocal a little more interesting. Obviously, the more we have to work with, the better. But fret not, because I am going to teach you some tricks that I've used in the past on vocals where the vocalist only sent me one track. And I had to work with what I had. So let's just do it. Tip number one is panning. And so now you're probably like, well, what the hell are we panning exactly? I only have one track. What am I supposed to do with this? Let me explain. So you're gonna wanna duplicate your vocal track two times so that you now have three copies of it. Send them all to separate mixer channels and process them the same way. Keep the first one dead center. Don't touch the panning on it. But for the next two, you want one all the way to the left and the other one all the way to the right, and route them both to the same channel so we can like mix them together, but you still want them to each have their own vocal processing on it. And on the track that you route them to, throw an EQ on it so we can cut out a lot of the low and mid range, and we can also tune the overall volume of it. We're not done yet. The next thing we want to do, and this part is pretty important, so pay attention. We need to move the two tracks that are panned. One of them we need to move slightly to the left, and one of them we need to move slightly to the right so that we don't get phasing. That's the one thing we want to avoid here. And you can kind of play around with how far you move each one. Just use your ear to kind of decide what sounds best for your song, because the further you move it apart, the more like dissonance, I guess, like it separates it a little too much, you know, if you go too far. So like kind of play with it a little bit. The next thing I'm going to show you is what I like to call faux harmonies. I don't know if that's the real name. I don't know if it has a name, but that's what I'm going to call it. That's what I've called it ever since I started doing it. And yeah, we're just going to call it that. I don't care. Obviously, a separate harmony track is going to make things easier, but that's not why you're here watching this video. You don't have a second harmony track. So a faux harmony can be accomplished in a couple of different ways. One of them is a preferred way. The other one is, you might get lucky, it might sound good. So the first way, it's easier, but you're probably not gonna get a sound you like. It really just depends. All you need to do is duplicate the vocal track and make it unique. Add it to a new mixer channel and throw on an auto-tune plugin. Make sure you're in the right key and set the speed as high as it can go. Next, play around with the sample pitch until it sounds like it harmonizes well. So you're just going to want to tune the pitch a little bit at a time, like 100 at a time, down or forward, like whichever way you want to go with it. I prefer lowering it personally, but you can also raise it. It's totally up to you. But you'll also want to make sure the volume of this track is pretty low, because you don't want people noticing that it's the same track just pitched down and nothing else has changed, and there's like really high auto-tune on it, because it's gonna sound like garbage. I'm laying in my bed, your voice is in my head. I'm laying in my bed, your voice is in my head. I think that I should. So the second, in my opinion, like I said, is the best way of doing it. And that would be using a pitch editor. Like in FL Studio, I use Nutone. I'm sure there's tons of other pitch editors out there. That's just the one I use and the one I'm going to be showing you. So basically, all you do is load the sample of what you want to harmonize. I wouldn't load the whole vocal track. I would make sure you isolate it and make it unique, drag it into the pitch editor, and from there you can alter the pitch accordingly. So to do this, you kind of need to understand what's going to harmonize and sound good. And I totally do this by ear, so you're more than welcome to do that. If you have knowledge of music theory, you're going to know what harmonizes. I have no f***ing knowledge of music theory, so I don't. So I just use my ear, and if it sounds good, I go with it. And if you want to kind of like play around with what harmonizes and what doesn't before you load it in, I would kind of get the melody of what you're saying. Like you can open up the current track in your pitch editor, and then you can see the MIDI of what exactly is going on with the vocal track. Open up like a piano or just a synth or something and lay those out, lay the MIDI out that is your vocals basically, and play around with dragging other pitches, other tones up above it to see if it sounds good together in the context of your song. You want to make sure everything's still in the right key and everything sounds good together. But, you know, you just got to kind of play around with it. And that's literally all I do when I make music is trial and error of just trying things. And this is definitely a big example of that. And then from here, once you've actually got the pitch down that you want to go with inside of your new tone or whatever pitch editor you're using, you can just click this button, drag it out, and then you have it, a harmonized vocal track. One thing I do like to do with these as well is I kind of like to keep them in the background so they're not front center. Of course, this is personal preference. So I throw a lot of EQ on it and I kind of cover up a lot of the highs on it. Same with the lows. I'll cut the lows, obviously. Don't want it to be too low. And it really just depends on the sound of the vocals. Like if new tone, sometimes with new tone, you kind of need to make things sound robotic to get it the way you want it. And so you really don't want that front and center for people to hear it.
I'm laying in my bed, your voice is in my head. Dead. I'm laying in my bed, your voice is in my head.
Now, the third way of kind of spicing up vocals is probably the easiest one in the whole list. It's just lowering or raising the pitch of a duplicated track. So you'll just take the track, you duplicate it, and you either raise it or lower the pitch depending on what you're going for. I've always found that going a full octave up or down is the best way to do it because you're going to be in the same key no matter what. And you definitely want to take the same approach of hiding it as much as you can as the last one, where it's just sitting in the background. You notice it's there, but it's not prominent. It's not super prominent that it's there. It's just more of like an accent, you know? It's just a touch. And so I've used it in several songs. In fact, I'm using the same example as number two. I did both here. I did the faux harmony and I did a lower vocal at the same time. And yeah, with this track, you definitely want to cut the lows as much, especially if you dropped it an octave. You're going to want to cut the lows a lot. I also drop a lot of the highs. It's just kind of that one range. It's like a medium range that you can hear. And I just think that sounds the best. Personal preference, you know?
Dead. I'm laying in my bed. Your voice is in my head. I think that I should get up, but I'd rather die instead.
All right, number four, vocoder. Layering a vocoder, it can have both a positive and a negative. I feel like all the tips on this list can have a positive or a negative, just depending on how you use it. Vocoder is definitely, it's more friendly with EDM. I would feel like it sounds better in EDM, but you can use it in a lot of things. I mean, The Weeknd uses it, or he has in the past. Starboy definitely has vocoder on it a lot. I think a lot of songs from that album actually just have a bunch of vocoder, and they're not even exactly backing tracks, really. Sometimes they are, but that's a tangent. Anyway, this one is still pretty easy. You're going to want to get a synth that's kind of has a bite to it. So like a saw wave or something, you know, it needs to be a sharper tone than like a sine wave or, you know. You're going to play the chord progression that you have, that you want over the vocals, essentially, with the synth. And then you're going to duplicate the vocal track that you already have. And you're going to make that unique, like all these, you make these unique, and route that to another channel. Okay, I'm using vocodex. So the way that this works in FL Studio, I'm not sure how all other vocoders work. I have no idea. I haven't played around with any of them. This is the one I know. So this is what I'm showing you how to use. You're going to have two tracks. So you're going to have your chord progression in one, then you're going to have your vocal in the other, and you're going to route both of those into a third mixer channel. And in that mixer channel is where you're going to want to throw vocodex, right? So in vocodex, you're going to have these two boxes at the top. And I think they're going to start off, if there's nothing being routed into the channel, it's going to say 00. But if there's something being routed in, I think it's going to say 0 or 10. And basically, the first box is what you want your vocal track to be. So if you right click it, you can actually see like what track channel, the track channel names. And so you're going to want to select the vocal track for that one. And then for the second one, you want it to be the synth. And then you can play around with these settings and make it sound, you know, more robotic, more human. It really just depends. This is personally the settings I am going with for this one. This track didn't originally have a vocoder on it. I needed to make it for this tutorial, actually. I don't know if I'm going to end up going with this for the final version of this song, but, you know, for now, the tutorial, it works. The pain's insane and goddamn, I can't take the hurt. Last but not least is formant shifting. And for this one, I've got to say it works better for verses. Like, I don't think this would sound great in a hook or anything like that. I use AutoTune Pro for this. I'm sure, like, with all these plugins, I'm sure there's more that you can go out there and check out how to do. But in AutoTune Pro, all you need to do is click this formant button here. You're going to wiggle this throat position around a bit. And from there, go to Tools, Last Tweaked, and then Create Automation Clip. And so when you play around with this, you can hear that it sort of, I don't really know. It's just changing the formant on it. So it sounds like it's getting lower or getting higher. And, you know, this is actually an effect that Black Bear, I believe, uses it a lot in a lot of his songs. You can definitely hear him using them. When you hear his voice and it sounds like it's getting lower, this is the effect he's using. It's this formant shifting. But I was wrong, guess I misjudged the situation. Silly me, misreading communication. Feeling hot, I could use some ventilation. Now I'm popping the bottle to some prescription medication. Wrong, guess I misjudged the situation. Silly me, misreading communication. Feeling hot, I could use some ventilation. Now I'm popping the bottle to some prescription medication. But yeah, that's pretty much the video, guys. It's been a long time since I've done one of these, so I'm sorry if it was kind of all over the place. I have a script, tried to follow it, didn't work, kind of went off on several tangents, but I hope you found something useful out of this. Let me know in the comments if you did, and please, if you are new here or if you've seen me and you're just not subscribed, how about this? If you're not subscribed, just subscribe, you know, hit the bell notification too. Like, that would be super dope if you did that. I post a lot. I don't currently, but I'm going to be uploading weekly, different content. I've got lots of stuff planned, tutorials, discussions, music, remixes, just stuff like that. I'm going to be posting. And if you want to keep up to date with all that, make sure you're subscribed and hit the bell notification. Please hit the thumbs up, comment on the video if you have a question or you want to see me cover something that you don't know. And FL Studio in particular, that's what I mainly use. That's the only thing I use. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you later. While I have you here, you should check out How to Make Mellow Trap. It's a tutorial I made over 2 years ago. People found it pretty helpful. Or if you want to listen to some new tunes, I have a new single, I Hope You're Doing Well. And I do hope you're doing well.